Karen. Today I'm going to be teaching you how to fit lobster and crutches in sitting, how to confirm the fit in standing, how to get your patient from sitting to standing using the lobster and crutches, and also I'm going to be comparing them to the usage of axillary crutches and to canes. To fit the lobster and crutches, you're going to begin with your patient sitting in their wheelchair with their knees at 90 degrees, and then you're going to move the wheelchair arm. You're going to ask the patient what their height is to get an idea of what measurements should be. So Colleen, what is your height?
5'2".
All right. And then you're going to be taking two measurements. You're going to measure from the greater trochanter of the femur to the lateral condyle of the femur. And then you're going to measure from this lateral condyle down to the base of the heel. All right. And then the height of your crutches is going to be the sum of these two measurements. So the first thing that you're going to be checking when you're confirming the height of the lobster and crutch is that the grip is at the same height of the ulnar styloid process. But you're also going to make sure that when the grip is placed on, so you can go ahead and place this on, that the grip is 1.5 inches away from the olecranon process. And then you can also adjust the cuff to fit the forearm better by squeezing it together. You want to make sure that it's tight enough that it does not fall off when you move your arm. And you want to make sure that it's not too tight so it's gripping the patient's arm. There are two methods to stand from sitting in the wheelchair. This is going to be the turnaround method. So you're going to begin with the patient's wheelchair locked, which I have confirmed that it's locked on both sides. And you're also going to have the patient in the gait belt and hold onto the gait belt at all times. Next, Colleen, I'm going to have you reach both of your arms to grab the arms of the wheelchair. And then I'm going to have you slide forward. So your bottom is at the edge of the wheelchair. Next, I'm going to have you roll onto your hip, knee position, your feet to the center of the wheelchair and stack them. All right, now you're going to reach with one arm to reach the opposite side, and then reach with the opposite arm to reach the opposite arm of the wheelchair. Next, I want you to do a push-up so that you're facing the wheelchair. Good. All right, from this position, you're going to have your patient shift all their weight to one side and reach for the lobster and crutch on the opposite side. After that, they're going to put all of their weight through the crutch to reach for the other crutch. Next, they're going to stand up by maintaining a C shape in their spine. This is the power-up method. You're only going to use this method for people with a lot of upper body strength, as this is a more challenging position. So you're going to begin again with the wheelchair locked, and you're going to place the gait belt around the patient and hold on to the gait belt at all times. Next, you're going to have the patient scoot forward in the wheelchair so their bottom is at the edge of the seat. Next, you're going to have the patient reposition the crutches so that their shoulders are in extension. And the patient is now going to place all their weight through the grips to stand up, maintaining the C shape in their spine. Crutches forward so that they're in a more stable position. Forearm crutches can be used for patients with the same impairments and gait patterns as those who use axillary crutches, with the exception that those who have decreased trunk stability will have to use the axillary crutches. Canes can be used for those who require slight decreases in weight bearing or who have decreased balance. They provide limited stability to the patient. Forearm crutches can decrease weight bearing by shoulder depression and elbow extension. They're preferred long-term by patients because they provide easier maneuverability and the ability to use the hands without dropping the crutches. And then put all their weight through that crutch and reach for the opposite crutch. Measuring from the lateral condyle of the femur. Okay. The patient's wheelchair is locked and that their gait belt is placed around their stomach. I don't know what to say.
I'm Mallory.